A square box has 6-inch sides. What is its volume? So the formula for volume is length times width times height. So how long it is, how wide it is, and how high it is. I'll do a little diagram for you guys. Well, that was really bad. So the one side is the length, how wide it is the other side, and then how high it is the height. Since we're dealing with a cube here, all the sides are the same length, and so I say 6-inch sides square. So this side is 6, the width is 6, and the height is 6. For volume, in case you don't know, it's basically the area. So one side, the area, length times width will give you the area of one side, and then you basically are multiplying that by however high it is, whatever your dimensions are, to get the volume for the whole figure. Oh, camera slipping. So to get what this whole value is, all the inside of that object. So for me, I wouldn't even have to go this far for this problem. I already have it underlined because I've done this, tried to record this like 5 times. But anyway, for me, because I know for the volume, I'm going to be multiplying the same number 3 times. And I know 6 times 6 is 36, and the only answer over here that's higher than 36 is 216. So I already know that 216 cubic inches is going to be my answer. But if they had better options over here that would be a little closer, then you had to do the math out. I'm just going to do the math out for you guys. So to find the volume equals length, which is 6, times width, how wide it is, which is 6, times the height, which is 6. So 6 times 6 equals 36, times 6 again, 6 times 6, 36, put the 3 up top, 6 times 18, or 6 times 3 is 18, plus 3 is 21. Equals 2216. Well, I can't even talk. And that, our answer, since we're multiplying inches times inches times inches, that's going to be 216 cubic inches. Okay. That's how you get the answer, the simple way. If you guys want a little bit more explanation, I'm going to keep going to just give some other tips on how you could solve a problem like this, or to understand a problem like this. So cubic inches, the term cubic means times 3, since you're multiplying inches, inches times inches times inches, because you have the 3 sides. That is 1, 2, 3. So you have inches cubed. I can't even spell or write. Inches cubic. Wow. So that happens when you're trying to hold the phone, talk, and explain. Inches cubed, or cubic inches. You can switch them around, it still means the same thing. Which also may be written out as inches cubed, so that doesn't throw you off. The little 3 above something means that it's cubed. That means whatever it is times 3. You have x cubed, that means x times x times x. just another little pointer, if you have x squared, that basically means x times x. Okay, so whatever it is, you're multiplying it by itself. And that's what that little 2 up top means. And these answers over here, why they chose these answers is for people that don't know what they're doing, pretty much. So you come up with 18 if you, one, you use the wrong formula. You use the formula for area of something instead of volume. Area is length times width, and you'd also have to do that wrong. If you add them instead of multiplying them, added 6 plus 6, then you would come up with, or 6 plus, no. Sorry. If you knew that volume was the three dimensions, length, width, and height, but you added them instead of multiplying them, then you would get 6 plus 6 plus 6, which would equal 18. If you use the wrong formula, and you use area instead of volume, and you added them instead of multiplying them, did 6 plus 6 instead of 6 times 6, then you'd come up with 12 cubic inches. And if you just multiply the two dimensions, length and width, which is the area, then you would come up with 36 inches instead of multiplying all three, which would be 6 times 6 times 6, and come up with the correct answer of 216. So it's kind of a long explanation for how you get the answer and how to not get the wrong answer. So just remember that volume is the three sides, how long something is, how wide it is, and how high it is. And you have to multiply each of the sides together to get your answer, and your answer is cubed. Sometimes they'll try and trick you up and not have the answer in cubic measurements, and they just might have just the number or anything else. But remember, your answer is cubed. All right, thanks. Like, subscribe, share the video, and I will see you in the next one.